Hello everyone, Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to Dr. Teeth. Let us start today with a new subject, that is dental anatomy. Now, if you are a first year dental student, I understand that you have entered a brand new field of dentistry and there are many things you are not sure about. There are many things that you might find confusing at first, but with these videos, my aim is to simplify the subject for you, and I hope as you reach towards the end, you will be amazed that God has made us with a lot of perfection. These are my Dr. Teeth notes. You can get access to these notes as a soft copy and it will also be available as a hard copy. So you can message us and check if it is available for ordering as a hard copy. Let's start by building the concepts. I'm sure you are aware of the fact that newborns do not have any teeth in their oral cavity till the first 6 months of their life. But there are exceptions, and these exceptions are called the neonatal and the natal teeth. Okay, these are called the natal and the neonatal teeth. Neonatal teeth is the one where the child has their first teeth erupt within the first month of their birth. The natal teeth is that where the child already has a teeth in his or her mouth when they are born. Okay, so otherwise for majority of the cases we have till 6 months no teeth. Okay, thus the first tooth in the oral cavity is seen between 6 to 9 months. This 6 month is not fixed. It's not that every child will have the first teeth erupt at the age of 6 months. It can vary between 6 to 9 months. Later, all different types, shapes, sizes, functions of tooth erupt in the oral cavity according to pattern, that is chronology. That pattern is called as the chronology. So if somebody asks you what is the chronology of deciduous teeth, which are the milk teeth, you have to tell the pattern in which they erupt. Okay, we'll see what pattern they are erupting in, means which tooth is coming in the oral cavity first and which tooth later. That's something we'll see as we proceed. Now, human dentition is diphodont type of dentition. What do you mean by diphodont? It means we have been gifted with two sets of dentition. We have the milk teeth and we have the permanent teeth, okay? Doodh ke daant or permanent daant. Now, milk teeth are named so because of the color of the tooth. The color is so white that it resembles a milk, and not because it is made up of milk, okay? So we have seen that we have two sets of dentition, okay? We have two sets of dentition, and these teeth, they erupt in three stages of human dentition. Means, in the human being, we have three stages. First is the primary dentition. Second is the mixed dentition. What is mixed dentition means? Means here, few teeth will be the milk teeth and few teeth will be the permanent teeth. So that is the stage where our milk teeth are falling out and the permanent teeth are erupting. That is the mixed dentition period. So we have the primary dentition, the mixed dentition and the permanent dentition. So we have different names for it, like the primary dentition is also known as the deciduous dentition. Mixed is also known as transient dentition. Permanent is also known as succedaneous dentition. Now primary dentition, it is from 6 months to 6 years of age. Okay, let me just make it very clear here. Remember this, that the first milk teeth erupts at 6 months of age and the first permanent teeth erupts at 6 years of age. Okay, milk teeth erupts at 6 months of age and permanent teeth erupts at 6 years of age. Now coming to mixed dentition period, it is between 6 years to 12 years. Okay, and the permanent dentition is after 12 years, you know, till the third molar erupt. Alright, now from this we come to a bubble moment, that is we get two sets of dentition in three stages. These two sets are the milk and the permanent teeth, and these three are the stages. Now in the oral cavity, we have two arches. What are arches? Basically jaws. You have the upper jaw that is called as the maxilla and the lower jaw which is known as the mandible. So we have two arches, the maxillary and the mandibular arches. And we have also seen that two successive sets of teeth are erupted during lifetime. First, we have a deciduous dentition. There are total 20 teeth in the mouth of the child. Okay, if you have a child in your house, go and see, you will find they have 20 teeth in their mouth. Okay, if they have all erupted. And that means we have 10 teeth per jaw. Let us see them. See, this is the maxilla, right? We have divided the upper and the lower arches into quadrants. Quadrants mean 1/4. 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, right? So, this is the first quadrant. The right maxillary portion is called the first quadrant. Always remember that. This will be very important to know that the right maxillary is the first quadrant. Left maxillary is the second quadrant. Okay? So, always imagine it like the right upper of the patient is the first quadrant. Left upper is the second. Okay? Then lower right is the third quadrant and lower left is the fourth quadrant of the patient. Okay, so let us see. The deciduous teeth, as you can see, this is the central incisor, the first tooth, central tooth. This is the lateral, this is the canine, right? This is the first molar and we have the second molar. So if you have read little bit about anatomy, you might be knowing there is one tooth here also, that is the premolar, which is not present in the deciduous teeth. We don't have premolar in the deciduous dentition. We only have it in the permanent dentition. So same here. This is the CI. This is the lateral. This is the canine. This is the first molar. And this is the second molar. Okay. Also, we don't have the third molar in the primary. So total, we have 5 teeth in each quadrant. So in the maxilla, we have 10. In the mandibular, we have 10 again. Okay. So, the deciduous dentition, the eruption will start at 6 months. The first tooth to erupt in the oral cavity is the lower central incisor, deciduous central incisor. And it lasts for up to 2 to 3 years of age. So, if you have a look at a child who is 3 to 4 to 5 years of age, you will find that all 20 teeth are present in his mouth. And usually we have spacing between their teeth. We will study all this in ortho, why we have spacing and all. But for now, let's concentrate on the anatomy, okay? So here, if you notice, I have numbered these teeth as A, B, C, D, E, right? So milk teeth are denoted by alphabets. And when we move to the permanent, you will find that permanent teeth are denoted by letters, right? We'll see why there is numbering system. We have given different numbering system to these teeth. Now coming to the permanent dentition. Permanent dentition replaces the deciduous dentition, we all know. And we have 32 teeth, that is 16 teeth per jaw, means maxilla has 16, mandible has 16. And that makes 8 teeth per quadrant. See, 1 to 8. And again, we have the same quadrant. The first quadrant is the right maxillary quadrant, second left maxillary, third left mandibular. This is the patient, not your, okay? This is the patient's right maxillary quadrant. Alright. And also notice here we have the premolars here. We have 2 premolars in the permanent. And also we have a 3rd molar in the permanent. Okay. Here the eruption starts at 6 years up to 18 to 20 years of age. And notice that the permanent teeth are denoted by letters. Yes, we have noticed that already. Let's talk about the dental formula. Now, dental formula, in logo kuch samajh nahi aaya, toh unhone dental formula bhi bana diya to ask you in the examination basically. I don't understand where we use it now, but still, dental formula for the primary deciduous teeth in human is this. So, the formula is I 2 by 2. That means we have 2 incisors in the maxilla and 2 incisors in the mandible. Then the canine, 1 canine in the maxilla, 1 canine in the mandible. Then molars, 2 molars in the maxilla, 2 molars in the mandible. Okay, so total we have 10 in each jaw and total we have 2 jaws, right, maxilla, mandible. So we have total 20 teeth. That is the dental formula for humans. So basically, I was kidding in the beginning by saying that just to ask you questions. the dental formula for humans is different, for animals are different, like for rabbits and all. So these things are asked in your examination. It's just for general knowledge. So keep that in mind. So here we have described it, like the formula has been elaborated here. Incisor 2-2, canine 1-1 and so on. Now for the permanent dentition, we also have this formula. See here. Incisor again 2-2, canine 1-1. We have premolars which are added. That is 2-2 and the molars are 3. So total 16 into 2, that is 32 teeth. Right? Because we have 2 jaws. Now let's talk about the eruption sequence. Basically, the chronology term we had heard in the starting, right? Like, which teeth erupts when? So, for the deciduous dentition, the first tooth to erupt is the A of the mandible. What is the A of the mandible? The central incisor of the mandible. Then, upper central incisor, upper lateral incisor, lower lateral incisor, lower first molar, upper first molar, upper canine, lower canine, then lower second molar, and then the upper second molar. That is the eruption sequence. That is how they erupt, like this. This is how it is going, okay? Now, the eruption sequence of the permanent dentition, it has been shown in this diagram. Let us start with the mandible first because it is easier to remember. Why? Because it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Only 6 has been replaced from here to here, okay? Now, what is this 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Let us understand it here, okay? 6 is the first molar, this one, this tooth, okay? So, this is the first one to erupt, okay? Then, we have the 1. So, this central incisor is the first tooth, central incisor 1. You remember the nomenclature? We have seen 1, 2, 3, 4, right? The numbering. So, this is the first tooth and its position, that is, its eruption is second, okay? And then we have the 2, means this tooth. What is the eruption sequence? It is the third tooth to erupt and so on, right? So it is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. And for the maxilla, we have 6, 1, 2, which is same as here. But we have 4, 5, 3, 7. That means the fourth tooth, which is here, the first premolar, is the fourth one to erupt. And the fifth tooth is the fifth one to erupt. And here the third tooth, which is the canine, okay? This is the first, this is the second, this is the third. So the canine is the sixth one to erupt. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay? It erupts at the sixth position. And then we have the 7, which erupts at the seventh position. So I hope it is clear. Let's talk about the tooth numbering system that will be covered in the next video.